GMA investigates the new crash test that could change the rules for school bus safety around the country. What officials saw in these tapes that could make the buses safer for children.
7:41, and GMA investigates school buses and why the vast majority of them do not have seatbelts. Some saying that seatbelts could prevent some injuries and save kids' lives. And now the government's auto safety agency tells ABC he's taking a fresh look at the issue. ABC's Paula Faris here now with that story. And good morning to you, Paula.
Good morning, Lara. And this morning, the vast majority of school buses on the road taking our children to school are not equipped with safety belts. It can be a really confusing message to kids. Buckle up, it's the law in most states, except on the school bus, but that could be changing.
This is the inside of a school bus rolling over. Luckily, it's a crash test with dummies, not the real thing.
Oh my gosh, it's a school bus.
Michael Watkins was 9 when his school bus crashed into a bridge, killing the driver, one student, and leaving dozens of other students injured, including Michael.
I broke my leg, my femur.
Do you think that he would have suffered the extent of those injuries had he been wearing a seatbelt?
All I know is he wasn't in one, and he ended up with a broken femur, 2 surgeries, a wheelchair, walker, therapy.
U.S. regulations only require seatbelts on small school buses under 10,000 pounds, and only 6 states require all school buses to be equipped with seatbelts. So GMA Investigates was on the scene at a crash test run by IMMI, one of the leading providers of seatbelts in the school bus industry. Inside, 12 dummies, 8 unbelted, 4 belted. High-speed cameras capture what happens when a bus rams into a wall at 30 miles an hour.
Oh my gosh, that was terrifying.
Inside, take a look at this 6-year-old turned around without a seatbelt.
Was this kid right here? Regardless, he flew out.
IMMI says that in general, when worn properly, lap shoulder belts can reduce injuries and fatalities by 50%. And if you think that crash seemed bad, experts say a high-speed rollover crash could be catastrophic. So IMMI moved those dummies to a second bus. Now, 5 crash dummies, 2 belted, 3 unbelted, to see what might happen in a rollover.
You can see that the 2 children that are belted, they're in their compartments and they're safe. The children that are unrestrained, they're thrown throughout the vehicle and they hit hard surfaces.
For years, the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration has refrained from mandating seatbelts on school buses, saying that because of the way school buses are built, they're inherently safer than cars. And NHTSA has been concerned that the higher cost for buses would divert more students into cars, driving up fatalities and injuries. So we wanted answers.
If seatbelts save lives, why isn't there a federal mandate?
This issue is going to be looked at to see whether or not there's more for us to do. Seatbelts unquestionably save lives.
Just weeks into his new role as NHTSA's top dog, Mark Rosekind is now promising a full review.
Is this an about face for your agency?
I'm the new guy, fresh eyes. Does that mean we might change things? We may. We're going to look for every action we could take to help those kids be safer.
And Rosekind tells me he wants the agency to move swiftly in its review and repeatedly said seatbelts save lives. If you're wondering how much it would cost, NHTSA estimates roughly $2.5 billion to make sure that every child is buckled up.
Seems to be worth it if it saves lives.
It does.
Absolutely. Thank you, Paula.
Thank you so much, Paula.